हेलो व्यूअर्स, दिस इज उमारेण महापात्र। वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल विथ ए न्यू वीडियो, वॉइस चेंज इंट्रोगेटिव सेंटेंसेस। इन दिस वीडियो आई हैव ट्राइड टू मेक द एक्सप्लेनेशन आज इज आज पॉसिबल। वॉच द वीडियो टिल द एंड फॉर द मोस्ट बेनिफिट। वॉइस चेंज इंट्रोगेटिव सेंटेंसेस। वी नो दैट देर आर टू काइंड्स ऑफ इंट्रोगेटिव सेंटेंसेस। One is yes or no question, another is WH question. Yes or no question starts with do verbs, be verbs, and also with have verbs, and also with modals. But WH words, WH sentences starts with the WH words. At first, I'll be explaining voice change of yes or no questions. Do, does, did. The sentences starts with do, does, did. Does he need a pen? Here, as per the tense, we change the active voice into passive. As per the tense, we use be verbs. Does he need a pen? Need is the verb here, and he is the subject, and object is a pen. When we change the sentence into passive, as it is a simple present, does is there, so it is simple present, and as per the object we use the be verb. As object is singular, we use be verb is. So is a pen needed by him? Is needed, be verb added, and the given verb will be past participle in passive structure. Do you write a lesson? Write what? A lesson. So, is a lesson written by you? Written. It became written, and be verb is added. Do you like the rooms? Like what? The rooms. Are the rooms liked by you? Be verb are is added, and the given verb became past participle, liked. Did she help them? Did is there, so it is simple past. Help whom? Them. So, its subjective form will be they. As it is plural form, so be verb will be added. Where? Were they helped by her? Did he complete the task? Complete what? The task. So, was the task completed by him? Then, be verb is, am, are, was, were. Are they plowing the lands? Notice the sentence, are plowing. Be verb plus ing. Already be verb is there. What I told, in every passive structure, another be verb will be added. If be verb is there, another be verb will be added. So be verb are is there, and the given verb will be past participle. So verb is what? Plow, plowing. It will be past participle, plowed. So to show its ing, what will be added? Being is added. Being is one be verb. It is added as being to show its ing form. So plowing what? The lands. So what will be? Are the lands being plowed by them? Is he painting the wall? Painting what? The wall. So is the wall being painted by him? Am I respecting the elders? Respecting whom? The elders. Two WH words we ask question. One is what, another is whom. For a person we ask whom. So are the elders being respected? Are the elders being is added, respected, be verb, past participle form of verb. Was he washing the clothes? Washing what? The clothes. So were the clothes being washed by him? Were you serving your parents? Serving whom? Your parents. Were your parents being served? Being served by you. Then have had. Has he spoken English? Has spoken means it is one. perfect tense, present perfect. So spoken what? English. Be verb will, what be verb will added? Been is added. So has he spoken English? Has English been spoken? As spoken already is the third form of verb, past participle. That past participle verb will be written and be verb is added as been. Have they played a match? Played what? A match. So has a match been played? Has he counted the beads? Have the beads been counted by him? Had they answered my questions? Had my questions been answered by them? Then modals. Modals means can, could, may, might, should, shall, will, would, etc. And we know that every modal verb takes one present form of a verb. So can, control, may, cross, should, cut, will, win, would, repair. When you change the sentence into passive, be will be added as be form. So can she control the situation? Control what? The situation. When you change the sentence into passive, so the situation will be the subject. The situation will be the subject. So can the situation be controlled? That can be is added and the verb became past participle controlled. May he cross the river? Cross what? The river. May the river be crossed. Should he cut the wood? Cut what? The wood. So what will be? Should the wood be cut? Cut, cut, cut. Three forms are same. Will they win the match? Win what? The match. So will the match be won? Would you repair the car? Repair what? The car. So be repaired. Okay. Double H questions. We know that double H questions start with what, when, where, why, whom, who, etc. Why have you broken the mirror? Here double H word why. And double H word why. And tense is have broken means present perfect. Broken what? The mirror. Okay. When you change the sentence into passive, that WH word will be in front in the passive structure. And as per the tense, we change into passive. As it is a present perfect, we should add been there and the object will be subject. So, why has the mirror been broken? By you. Why do you write an article? The same thing, why is there? So, you write why in front. And do write means it is a simple present. Okay. It is a simple present. Do write means it is simple present. So, do write means it is simple present. So, what verb will be added? An article is the right what? An article. So, we should add there is. So, why is an article written by you? When will you return my pen? What is the verb here? Written. Written what? My pen. So, my pen is object. You write when in front. Then, as per the object, that will be subject in front. So, you write the verb. So, my pen will. So, what will be? When will my pen be? Be verb be is added and be returned by you. Why are you laughing at her? Are laughing at means what? It is one continuous sentence, present continuous. At her, laughing at whom? Her. So her is the object here. It's a subjective form she. So what be verb will take? Is. So why will be why there? Why is she being laughed? Why is she being laughed? Where did you put the things? Put what? The things. It is one simple past. Did put means it is simple past. So, which verb will be added? Was or where? As per the subject we should add. So, things will be subject there. Where will be? Where? Where the things put by him. Put is the past participle form. Three forms of a put is same. Put, put, put. What did he broke? He broke. He broke what? I mean what? He broke what? So what was broken by whom? Understand? Simple past it is. So what was broken by him? Understand? It, this is subject. He broke what? Okay. So what if the what was broken by the here broke? What is the object? And it will be subject in the passive structure. What was broken by him? Then the sentences framed by whom or who or whom? Who solved the problem? Who is the subject? Who solved what? The problem. That means the problem is the object. When you change the sentence into passive structure, that a WH word will be there. So you write, that means what will be, you think it in the assertive, who solved the problem? The problem, that means you suppose someone's name is there. So what will be? The problem was solved by that person. So by whom? So you write, who is in front? Who was the problem solved by? Okay, that the problem is the object here, that will be subject. Who was the problem solved by? Who has deceived? So it is one perfect tense, present perfect. Who has deceived you? So you is the object. When you change the sentence into passive, that will be subject. So that will be subject. So by whom? Who has deceived you? You have been deceived by whom? So you write in front whom. Whom have you been whom have you been deceived? Who have you invited? That means what? When you change the sentence into passive, what will be? Who has been invited? Whom have you invited? What will be? Who has been invited by you? That means you do. Who have you invited to? Who have you invited to? That will be what? Who has been invited by you? Here you is the subject. Okay. And invited to whom? This is object. So you write in front, who has been invited by you? Whom has she reported? Okay. That means she has reported to whom? So when you frame question as a passive, who has been reported by her?